My name is Louisa Fleet. I'm the CEO of Louisa Fleet Recruitment, and we help small to medium-sized businesses, exec level down, build and retain successful sales teams. And I've been established for about 8 years, and I've been a recruiter for over 20.
Fantastic. And in terms of the sales recruitment market and the pandemic, how have you seen things be impacted? Has there been a change in the kinds of skill sets and experience that companies are looking to hire? What kind of things have you seen that are different?
The pandemic has had a huge impact on the sales recruitment sector. I mean, even if we look at the numbers of people quoted on payrolls, I think it was in August, it was down 730,000, I think, between March and July. And the sales sector has been impacted hugely because salespeople deal face-to-face, and that wasn't possible anymore. So there's been a huge decrease in vacancies. And in terms of the skill sets, yeah, these have really needed to be looked at and redefined, leadership down. Leaders have had to, really sort of inspire from a remote perspective and lead yeah. their sales teams through such challenging times and a whole new way of working. And then when it comes to salespeople, they've had to completely change the way that they communicate. Well, everybody's had to change the way they communicate. And everybody from exec level down has had to learn to communicate online, to engage customers online, through social media, through videos. There have even been new job roles created purely around sort of remote working. I think head of remote working is a new job that I'm seeing coming up more and more again as a result of this pandemic.
Yes. And I'm hearing in various sectors that companies are increasingly having to offer flexible working, and remote working as something they're going to do long term just in order to be attractive to the best candidates. Are you seeing that when you're talking to sales candidates? Is that the kind of message that you're hearing, or is that less of an issue within sales?
Do you know, I'm a massive advocate of flexible working. My whole business has been built on hiring flexible workings and flexible workers, and that was over 8 years ago. So we've been driving towards this as a country for a long time, and the pandemic has forced many businesses to look at this when they've resisted it in the past. So, there have been industry sectors or particular old-fashioned kind of leaders that are a bit stuck in their ways that have refused to think that people can be trusted to work from home and to be effective. So I think there's been a lot of lessons in the pandemic about this. Number one, those people have been proven wrong. Number two, people can actually be productive from home. Number three, actually, home working isn't for everybody, and for some people it can be detrimental to their mental health. So yes, I do believe that companies should give the option of flexible working, and yes, I do believe that this will help businesses attract and retain good employees for longer. I think there should be the choice. I think we're living in a nation where, we've now embraced family values, family culture, and, I'm hearing from leaders that they're thinking, I'm not sick, I'm not, not wanting to go back to this international travel anymore. It's just not necessary. I don't need to be in head office all the time. All these things can be done over Zoom. Salespeople, they don't want to clock in and out of an office just to prove that they're working. They want to start work at 6 o'clock, some of them, and then go to the gym at 11 o'clock. And then you've got others that want to do the school runs, and then they want to put the laptop on after the kids have gone to bed. So it is definitely what candidates want, and it is definitely the way we need to move forward in the recruitment sector.
I guess the great thing about sales is it's very transparent whether, you're doing your job well and how you're doing your job compared to your peers, because the sales numbers don't lie, do they? So it's probably of all the sectors, it's the one where it's the easiest to feel comfortable with having people work at home like that.
Yeah, I mean, I think there is definitely there will be people that decide that maybe they might need to change jobs because actually they physically need people around them. There's a small proportion of people that, especially in sales where there's big personalities, they need to bounce off others. And I think remote working completely wouldn't work. I think in sales, you have to get together because it's all about recognition. It's about, you know, bouncing off of others and sharing ideas. And so I think the ideal solution is where you can have an office that you go into every now and again to meet with your colleagues, to share ideas, to recognize great performance. But actually, you can work around your family life and your personal commitments from home as well.
Yeah, completely agree. So tell me about the impact that the pandemic's had on your own business and you know, what kind of actions have you been taking there to adapt to everything that's happened?
Okay, so it's had a huge impact on my business. Oh my goodness. When I looked at the stats, 43% of our clients were actually companies that sold products or services or solutions into the hospitality and leisure sector. So, you know, I'm recruiting exec level down teams for those types of businesses. And that was nearly half of my business wiped out, companies that I've worked with for years and years. Wow. So, you know, we locked down, we just moved into offices, we moved everybody back, processes were frozen, recruitment was frozen, and just a massive drop in vacancies while companies figured out how they were going to approach selling and you know, how they were going to make their own businesses survive. So it was a really tough time. So what action did I take? Well, after the initial shock had gone, I took about to contacting my network of leaders, and I did find myself really, really lucky and grateful that I had such a great network around me that I could talk to and basically ask them how they were going about navigating these difficult times in this period of change. And do you know what? It was absolutely amazing, you know, what I was hearing about the challenges that people were facing and how they were dealing with those challenges. And I thought, this is too good information not to be shared because everybody's struggling. We need to share best practice. And so that was the driving inspiration behind my first initiative, which was the creation of the video YouTube channel Fast Forward. And this is a video interview channel where I interview leaders who have found new and unique ways of getting through difficult times. And these things go way past COVID. And, you know, for the people that are being interviewed, it's a great way for them to connect with their audience and to share their story in a really human way that some other marketing just can't really get across. And for the listeners, it's been quite a comfort for them to know that they're not the only ones to have gone through these kind of challenges. And it's kind of inspired them, you know, the solutions that have been offered of how businesses have got through. And then from there, obviously for everybody, there was a period of reflection, even though we worked throughout, it was an antisocial time. And I spent, you know, a lot of time thinking about the types of customers that I've got and what challenges they were going through. And I was thinking about the small businesses that were struggling to grow because they were fearful of recruiting. And, you know, they might have recruited before and had a bad hire. It's not worked out. It's been frustrating for them. It's cost them money, time. You know, they've lost customers. It's been a really painful experience for them. And I was thinking about how can I help and support these businesses to get over this fear of recruiting? Because you have to recruit to grow your business. As you quite rightly said the other day, you know, in order to build up a company, you need other people in the business that you can pass it over to. And then this inspired the Hire Your Own program. And this is a program that I've created to give business leaders of small businesses, equip them with the resources and the knowledge that I've got so they can actually hire their own people and do it well. So that was the second initiative that I've launched. And I'm really grateful that, you know, we've had this opportunity to reevaluate and reposition our business, and very excited now that we have, you know, more than one solution outside of just the pure recruitment offering to help and serve our customers better moving forward.